Welcome to Class 5 English Lesson, Who Will Be Ningto, Unit 10 from NCERT Marigold. Who will be Ningto? A king is called a Ningthau and a queen is called a Lema in Manipuri. This is a story from Manipur about what qualities make a good ruler. So children, a king is called as Ningthau and a queen is called as Lema in which language? In Manipuri. Okay, you can see the image here of a king and a queen, how different the dressing and all is. And from in which language it is called as Ningthau and Lema? In Manipuri. Manipuri is a language of which state? Of Manipur. In India, this northeastern state, you can see this red color, this is Manipur, children. Okay, in India it is a state called as Manipur, and there the language is Manipuri, and there the king is called as Ningthau and the queen is called as Lema. Okay, now we are going to discuss a story from Manipur about what qualities makes a good ruler. Who is a ruler, children? Who rules the kingdom? Ruler is nothing but a king who rules his kingdom. You might have listened of many rulers. Yes or no? Many kings' names you might have listened. For example, see kept here few: Prithviraj Chauhan, Ashoka, Rani Rakshmi Bai, Chhatrapati Shivaji, Maharana Pratap, and all. Like this, you might have seen many rulers. Yes or no? How you remember them? Because of their qualities. Because they were good rulers who ruled their kingdom. So similarly, now we are going to see one story from Manipur. Manipur is a state in India. It is a northern eastern state, and it is also among the seven sisters. Okay, and there, what is a king called as? Ningthau. What is a queen called as? Lema. Because different states have different languages. Yes or no? Like in north states we speak Hindi, in southern Tamil, Telugu, and all. Different states have different languages. Like that, in Manipur, what is the language? Manipuri. And we are discussing about the story of a king and a queen from Manipur, and they will tell us about the quality that makes a good ruler. So let's start the story. Long, long ago, in the land of Kanglepak in Manipur, there lived a Ningthau and a Lema. They were loved dearly by the people. The Ningthau and Lema, on their part, never stopped thinking about their Miyam. Miyam means people. Our Miyam should be happy, they said. The people were not the only ones who loved their Ningthau and Lema. The birds and animals too loved them. The Ningthau and Lema always said, everybody in Kanglepak should live in peace. Not only the people, but the birds, animals and trees. So these two people, that is the Ningthau and Lema, they were loved by all the people of their land, it seems. And what is the name of the land? Kanglepak. And it is in Manipur. Okay, children? And not only by the Miyam. Miyam means people. Not only by the people, they were loved by all the birds and animals also of their land, it seems. And they always used to tell that everybody in Kanglepak, that is their land, everyone should live in peace. Peace means there should not be any fight or any bad things. Everyone should be happy. And not only people, they used to think about their birds, animals and trees also. And their beloved king and queen had three sons, Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanatomba. So how many children they had? Three children, three sons. The name were Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanatomba. 12 years later, a daughter was born. She was named Sanatombi. She was a lovely child, soft and beautiful inside. She was loved by one and all. So, after 12 years, first they had three sons. And after 12 years, a daughter was born and they named her Sanatombi. She was also a lovely child, soft and beautiful, and everyone loved Sanatombi. The years went by and the children grew up well. And then one day, the Ningthau called all his ministers and said, it is now time to decide the Tungi Ningthau, the future king. So now all the children became big. So Ning Tao, one day he called all his ministers and he said, "Friends, now it's a time to decide Tungi Ning Tao." Tungi means future children. Tungi means future. That is who will be the next king. The ministers were shocked. But O Ning Tao, what is there to decide? Sanajoba, your eldest son will be a future king. Eldest means the first child. Ma, who is the first child? Who is the first child of the king? Sanajoba. So the ministers were shocked when the king said that we will decide the next king. They said, our eldest son, your eldest son will become the future king. Because children, at that times, when the king becomes old or when the children become big, the next king will replace the old king. Okay. And normally, whoever is the first son, means pehla beta jo bhi hai, he will become the king. Well, the Ning Tao replied, that's how it happened in old days. The eldest son always become the king, but times have changed. So let us select a king who is most worthy of becoming a king. So what did Ning Tao, that is the king, replied? It happened in old days like that. From olden days, we are doing that only. Whoever is the eldest son, that is, whoever is the first son, he will become the king. But now the times have changed. So let's select the king who is worthy of becoming a king. For example, in your class, a leader is selected or not? So no, when 40 to 50 children are there, one girl leader and one boy leader will be selected. So no, so how he will be selected? Who can speak nicely, whose voice is louder, who has a command over his voice, who knows all the teachers, all the children, who understand the children, like that only we can select. So no, one child who doesn't even speak to anyone, can we make them a leader? No, because they should be worthy of becoming a leader. Similarly, the Ning Tao, the king, said that whoever is worthy, we will select them as the king. We will have a contest to select the future king. Contest means competition. The Lama said, that is the queen said, we will have a contest, that is a competition. And so in the land of Kangla Park, there was a contest, a horse race. Do you know what is horse race? See, this is horse race. Okay. Whoever reached the Kongnak, the banyan tree, first would be declared Tungi Ning Tao. Tungi means what we said just now. Tungi means we said future. So who will reach the banyan tree? What is banyan tree called in Manipuri? Kongnak. Kongnak means banyan tree. See children, this is a banyan tree. It is very strong and is our national tree also. So no, it is very strong. So they kept a horse race that who will reach the Kongnak, that is the banyan tree, will become the Tungi Ning Tao. But then a strange thing happened. Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanatomba, all three of them finished the race together. So what happened, it means all three finished the race together. That is, all three reached the finishing line together. They were expert riders and all three reached the finish line at same time. There was great excitement. Excitement means what, children? They were very happy, a feeling of enthusiasm, eagerness. Look at them. The people shouted, Shagol Thoba Nupa. Means Shagol Thoba Nupa means such a fine horseman. Means how nice horse riding they have done. Who are horsemen? Horsemen who ride the horse. But one question remained. Who would become the Tungi Ning Tao? Yes or no? Because what was the contest? Who will reach first will become the king, future king. But all three reached first at the same time. Then who will be the Ning Tao? The Ning Tao and Lama turned to their sons. The Ning Tao said, Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanatomba, you have proved that you are fine horsemen. What did Ning Tao and Lama said to their sons? You have proved that you are very good horsemen. And do something different each one of you so that we can decide who will be Tungi Ning Tao. So what did they say? You have proved that you all are very good horsemen. You three are very good horsemen. You do something different so that we can select Etungi ningto. Suddenly, Sanajoba mounted his horse and held his spear straight in front of him. He looked around. There was a hush among people. What is Sanajoba, the eldest son, going to do? They thought to themselves. So what did Sanajoba did? He mounted his horse. Mounted his horse means he got up onto his horse and held his spear. Spear is a weapon used by hunters' children. Can you see this? This is the spear. It is very sharp. It is used by the hunter to hunt animals and all, because this will be very sharp. Okay. And then what he did? He mounted his horse. He took his spear in his hand. He looked around. There was a hush among the people. Hush means what, children? Silence among the people. You can see the image here. Like this, Sanajoba mounted his horse and he took the spear in his hand and kept it straight in front of him. He looked around and there was hush among the people. Hush means silence. Everyone was silent and thinking, what is Sanajoba, the eldest son, going to do? They thought to themselves. Sanajoba then looked at the huge cognac standing majestically in the distance. He pierced the tree and jumped his horse right through it. So majestically means very beautifully. Okay. He looked at the cognac, that is the banyan tree, standing at a distance. He pierced the tree. Pierced the tree means he divided the tree in between and then he jumped through it. Then everyone started shouting. It says, bravo, bravo. The people shouted, thauro, thauro. So, thauro means in Manipuri, it is called as thauro, and in English, what does it mean? Bravo, bravo means very brave. So no, because banyan tree is very strong tree, and he pierced it and he went through it. Now it was the turn of the second son, Sanayama. What would he do? Sanayama too looked at the cognac as he mounted his horse. Then he too rode towards the tree harder and harder. The people watched in silence, afraid even to breathe. When he was really close, he urged his horse to jump higher and higher. The horse rose until the horse and the rider jumped clear over the huge tree and landed on the other side in a wonderful motion. So what did the second son, that is Sanayama, did? It seems he also mounted his horse. Then he too rode towards the tree harder and harder, means very fastly, and the people all were in silence, afraid even to breathe. They were not even able to take the breath. So everyone were in silent and they were looking what will happen. And then he urged his horse, that is he told his horse to jump, and along with his horse he also jumped higher and higher till he rose above the tree and jumped over the huge tree and landed on the other side in a wonderful motion. So now what did the second brother, that is Sanayama, did? He jumped over the tree, over the banyan tree, to the other side wonderfully in a beautiful motion. Do you want to see how he jumped? This is the way he jumped. And this is just a small plant, but there he jumped over the banyan tree. Okay, children. Now, next, the people breathed in relief and said in unison, Pajay, Pajay. Pajay means what, children? Pajay means wonderful. Thauro means bravo. Pajay means wonderful. Everyone said in unison means unity at same time, that wonderful, wonderful. And now it was the turn of the youngest son, Sanathomba. He too rode his horse towards the cognac, and before anybody knew what was happening, uprooted it triumphantly. He carried the tree to the Ningthau and Lema and laid it at their feet. And what did the third son, Sanathomba, did? He also rode into his horse and then he uprooted the tree triumphantly. Triumphantly means victoriously, as if he has gained something. Banyan tree is very strong, that he has uprooted it. Uprooted means what? You can see in this image given here. See, what is uprooted? Removing the tree from its roots. Okay, children. So the next, the shouts of Thauro, Thauro, Pajay, Pajay filled the mountains. So everyone started saying Thauro, Thauro, that is bravo, bravo. And Pajay, Pajay means wonderful, wonderful. It filled the mountains. The people grew restless. Why were the Ningto and Lema taking so long to make the announcement? Now the king, the people of that land were thinking, why Ningto and Lema are not doing any announcement after the three have shown their beautiful stunts. They craned their necks to see what was happening. Crane their necks means to stretch towards an object of attention. You can see in this image, all are seeing what is happening. The Ningto and Lema were watching Sanatombi, the five-year-old daughter. She looked sad and lonely. She stared at the Kongnag, which lay dead by the throne. Birds flapped worriedly around, searching for their homes in the tree. Sanatombi walked up to the Kongnag and whispered, "The Kongnag Nag is dead. It was hurt by the spear and now it is dead." So flap means what, children? Flap means moving the wings. The birds flap, na? This is flapping. You can see this image. This is flapping. Okay. Now what happened? Ningto and Lema, what were they doing? They were watching their little girl, 5-year-old little girl, Sanatombi. She was very sad and lonely. Lonely means all alone. She went near to the Kongnag, which lay dead by the throne. Lay dead by the throne means because of that throne, that to become a king, what all they did? One made a hole, pierced a hole in that and jumped through it. One jumped over it. One, what did he do? He just uprooted the tree. Uprooted the tree means remove the tree from the ground itself. So will the tree live? Now what happens if you remove a tree or plant from the ground? If it roots, everything are broken, what happens? It will die again. It will not come, na? So Sanatombi walked up to the Kongnag and whispered. Whispered means what? Saying in low voice, speaking out in low voice, very softly. "The Kongnag is dead. It was hurt by the spear and now it is dead." The people were all attention. Then Ningto stood up. He looked at the three boys. He looked at the little girl. He turned to the people. "If anybody is worthy of becoming the ruler," he said, "it is Sanatombi." It was she who told us to look at the soul of Kongnag. Sanatombi feels the pain of others. She feels the pain of the people, the animals, the birds and the trees. Then what did the king said? That if anyone is becoming the king, it will be Sanatombi, because she is a person who showed the pain of that tree. Yes or no? Everyone were happy seeing that they have done that, this, everyone. So what happened at last? They hurted the tree. Yes or no? Again, can we plant back the tree? No. You have to put a seed. It will become small plant. How many years it will take to become a big plant? Yes or no? But what Sanatombi? She felt the trouble of that tree. So no, she felt the pain of that tree. So such people will only have the pain of the people, animals and birds. She has feel the pain of all those things. That's why the king said that she will be the king. "I declare Sanatombi the future Lema of Kanglipak." Lema means queen. So Sanatombi, as she is a girl, she can't be a king. She will be the queen, the queen of Kanglipak. Ningto said, a silence fell. Everyone turned to look at the little girl, the future queen. There she stood, all of the file, like a small Kongnag, with the birds flying all around her. They sat on her shoulders and on her head. She held out her hands full of grain and the birds flapped about her, pecking at the food. A Lema is the one who does not hurt anybody in the kingdom. Children, at last what happened? Sanatombi was declared as the Lema of Kanglipak. That is, that land Kanglipak, she was declared as the future queen. So she will become the lame, lama of the Kangrapai. Everyone were silent and everyone started looking at Sanatombi. All birds were flying around her. She kept few seeds in her hand which the birds were eating, and everyone, the birds were flapping and everyone were happy. And a lama is a one, let it be a king or a queen, that is, let it be Ningto or Lama, is a person who does not hurt anybody in the kingdom. So what is the quality of the ruler we learnt here? That they should not hurt anybody in the kingdom. Then only there will be peace in the kingdom. And this story is written by Indira Mukherjee. Okay, children, now let's look into the story in the form of a short play. Okay. Now, where is this story is taken place? In Manipur, and the land name is Kanglapak. And in the story, what we are going to learn about the qualities of a good ruler. And in this story, the two important people were Ningtau and Lema. Ningtau means king, Lema means queen. And they had three sons, Sanajoba, Sanatomba, Sanayama. And one beautiful daughter was also born after 12 years named Sanatombi. So now the Ningtau and Lema, they thought to keep a contest for the three children, that is Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanatomba, that who will reach the coconut tree first. Then what happened? All three reached at the same time. So everyone started shouting, Shagol, Toba, Nupa, means such a fine horseman. So then what happened? Then the Ningtau, the king, said that to prove their identity, to prove something special. So then what they did? Then first Sanajoba, he mounted onto the horse and then he went near to the coconut tree. And what he did? He pierced the tree and jumped right through it. Next was Sanayama's turn, and what did Sanayama then? He also mounted onto the horse and he urged his horse to jump, and jumped clearly over the huge tree. And the next turn was Sanatomba's turn, and what did Sanatomba did? Sanatomba uprooted the tree, that is, he removed the tree from the ground, and then he laid the tree at the legs of the king and the queen, that is Ningtau and Lema. And everyone started shouting, Thauro, Thauro, Pajay, Pajay. But what happened? And there was only one girl. Who is that? The little 5-year-old girl Sanatombi, who was feeling very sad and standing near the tree. Now Ningtau, Lema, everyone were watching her as she was very sad and lonely, and she stared at the dead coconut, and the birds were searching for their homes. So no, many birds build their nests in the tree, and when tree is laid down, what happened? Their nests will fall down. So no, there will not be a home for them. So Ningtau and Lema looked at the three boys and the little girl and turned to the people and declared Sanatombi as future Lema, that is future queen. Why? Because she feels the pain of the people, animals, birds and the trees. So Sanatombi stood like a small coconut, means small coconut means small banyan tree with birds flying all around. You can see in the picture. And a lama is the one who does not hurt anybody in the kingdom. Okay, children, what is the quality which we learned about the ruler in this lesson? That a lama, let it be a lama or Ningtau, a king or queen, is a person who does not hurt anybody in the kingdom. And this is not only a quality of a good ruler, every child should also be like that. You should not hurt anyone. Okay, you should have sympathy towards others. Let not only people, animals, birds, plants and all, we should not destroy trees or plants like that. Okay, children, understood this? Now let's look into the objective part of the lesson. Name the place in Manipur where Ningtau and Lema ruled. Ningtau and Lema ruled in the land of Kanglipak in Manipur. What is the name of the place, children? Kanglipak. K-A-N-G-L-E-I-P-A-K. Kanglipak in Manipur. Now, next question. Why did people of Kanglipak love their king and queen? The people of Kanglipak loved their king and queen because they loved the people and always thought of making them happy. Third question. Why did Ningtyo want to choose a future king? Ningtyo wanted to choose a future king because his children were now grown up to rule and take his position. How did the king want to select their future king? The king did not want to follow the old custom. He wanted to choose the future king by holding a contest of horse race. He wanted to see who was worthy of being the future king. Our next question. What kind of child was Sanatumbi? Sanatumbi was soft and beautiful from inside. She could feel the pain of others like animals, trees, birds and people. Next, sixth one. Have you ever seen an animal or bird in pain? What did you do? And this should be according to your experience, ma. That whether you have seen any animal or bird or a tree also you can write. Okay, in pain. In pain means if it is in trouble or anything, it got hurt or anything. And if so, what did you do? So it should be your own answer, children. And next one. Where is Manipur on the map of India? Where is the Manipur, ma? This is the map of India. And this red part is Manipur, children. Okay. And Manipur is in the northeastern part of India. Yes or no? This is northeastern part. This is east part, na? That's why northeastern part of India. What language do the people of Manipur speak? Actually, what did we say? Manipuri. Yes or no? And it is also called as Mathailon. What it is called as? M-A-I-T-H-A-I-L-O-N. Mathailon. Who do you think should have been made the future king, children? Sanajoba, the one who jumped through the tree? Sanayama, the one who jumped over the tree? Or Sanatumba, the one who uprooted the tree? Why do you think so? Who was made the future queen and why? And this should also be your own answer, ma. After seeing the lesson, you saw three people. Yes, no? Sanajoba, Sanayama, Sanatumba. What did the first boy did? He jumped through the tree. Yes or no? He pierced the tree. That is, he made a hole and he jumped through the tree. The second one over the tree. And the third one, he uprooted the tree itself. And why do you think? And who was made the future queen and why? That is the next question. So what can we say for that? Sanajoba? No, because he hurted the tree. Yes or no? He made the hole and he jumped through that. He hurted the tree. And Sanayama and Sanatumba, he totally uprooted the tree. The tree became dead. So the both cannot be. But Sanayama, he can be. Yes or no? Because why? Sanayama, the one who jumped over the tree, should have been made the future king. It is because he jumped over the tree without hurting the tree. What he did? He just jumped over the tree. So this is my opinion, children. What do you think? Sanajoba, Sanayama or Sanatumba, who could be made the future king? That you should write. And the next question was, who was made the future queen and why? Sanatumbi was made the future queen because she was the only one who could feel the pain of the people, animal, birds and trees. Now, say loud the following names in your mother tongue. Mother tongue means what, ma? Whichever is your language. Whichever language do you speak at home? For example, if you are from Andhra or Telangana, what would be your mother tongue? Telugu. If you are from Tamil Nadu, your mother tongue is Tamil. If you are from Kerala, your mother tongue is Malayalam. Like that. In Manipuri, Ningtyo means what is said in your mother tongue. Leima, what is said in your mother tongue? You have to write like that. For example, I'll tell in English. Okay, Ningtyo, king. Leima, queen. Meam, people. Kongnak, banyan tree. Okay, children. So now I'll tell in Hindi also. Like king is called as Raja in Hindi. Queen, Leima, Rani. Meam, people, Praja. Kongnak, banyan tree, bargat ka ped. So like this, you will write in your mother tongue what it is called as. Now, write the meanings of the following in English. तुंगी निंगतो, तुंगी निंगतो मीन्स फ्यूचर किंग, थाउरो थाउरो, ब्रेवो ब्रेवो, फजाय फजाय, वंडरफुल वंडरफुल, शगोल थोबा नुफा सच फाइन हॉर्समैन. ओके चिल्ड्रन, अंडरस्टूड ऑल दिस? Next, some interesting words sound like the noises for which they stand. You use different tone of voice when you say these words. The voice becomes louder and more forceful. For example, zoom when the car, bang when the door, pip pop, flippity plop. Say the following and write what would make these sounds or actions. Click. Where do you get the click sound, ma? Click. Where do we get? Camera. Yes. Chirp. And what chirps? Can you tell? Yes, birds. What chirps? Bird. Whisper. Night while sleeping, mosquito comes and whispers in mouth, screw and all. Yes, whisper. What is a whisper? It is talking in low voice. Okay. Next, bravo. When do we say bravo? It is said when someone is doing very well. Like when the horses and all, where they did all those stunts and all, na? That time they said, bravo, you are very good boy. Don't we say, ho, when it is expressed to express surprise or pain. You can express surprise also and we can express pain also. How? Tell me, ho, so beautiful it is. It was a surprising thing. So no, ho, it's paining me. It's a pain. And ha, to express pleasure. Okay, hooray, it is said to express happiness. Hooray, have won the game. Alas, it is said to express sadness. Alas, I lost it. Okay, wonderful. When do we say wonderful? When we are very happy and we want to express our pleasure, we say wonderful. Hi, it's a common thing to greet someone. Hi, how are you? Ho, it is said to attract someone's attention. Ho, don't go there. Like that. Okay. Hop away. It is a sound produced at the time of jumping. Okay, children, is it clear for you all? Now, next, read the lesson carefully and put a circle around all the action words with ed at the end. Then write them in one column and their present form in another. One is done for you. So what you will do, you will look into your textbook for this lesson and wherever the action words means verbs, action verbs, okay? Wherever the word ends with ed, you have to circle it and then you have to write here the present form also, like admitted. Admit. Present form means present which is happening. Action verb ed at the end. Admitted means already he has been admitted. He has been admitted in the hospital yesterday. So when ed comes, what is it? It is past. And the present form is admit. Admit him now in the hospital. Like that you'll do. Few examples I'll be giving here. Take time, pause this page and read all this. Okay. Like for example, leaved. Leave, pierced, pierce, flapped, flap, looked, look, walked, walk. This is present form. Present means which is happening in present. When it ends with ed, what happens? It has already been happened. Loud, jumped, brewed, stopped. Okay, understood? So pause at this place and you can see the words. Fill in the correct word in the blanks and complete the story. In a forest, there dash a goblin named Cruel. There, what will come here? This is past, yes or no? So, what becomes? Ed at the end, ed will come. So, it is lived, L-I-V-E-D, lived. One day, he dash an old man wandering in the forest. So, this is also past. He met. Because past, he met. Next, immediately, Cruel dashed onto the old man's shoulder. Cruel leapt, L-E-A-P-T, leapt onto the old man's shoulder and dashed him, let's go. And he ordered him. Okay, ED will be there at the end. Move fast. The frightened old man dashed the nasty goblin, obeyed the nasty goblin and dashed on and walked on. As they dashed on, as they moved on, he dashed that goblin's feet were very tender. he noticed that goblin's feet were very tender. The old man asked Cruel, "Sir, how are your feet so soft and tender?" Cruel replied, "I have taken a vow that I will not touch the ground with my feet till I wash them." Okay, children, they soon dashed to a pool. Came to a pool. Come will not be there. Okay, came to a pool. The goblin dashed the old man, instructed the old man to wait for him while he entered the pool. The old man thought to himself, "Now that the goblin has wet his feet, he does not need me. Let me run for my life or he will surely eat me up." So he ran off. Okay, children. So the words I underlined will be coming in the blanks here. I hope you understood all this. Make a list of action words from this story. Action words are nothing but action verbs. Okay, children. So what you will do? Leave, lived. Like that, action words you will take from the story only. And then irregular action words also. Meet, met. Like this also you will make it. Okay, children. Now few examples are leave, lived. Reply, replied. Come, came. Order, ordered. Obey, obeyed. Move, moved. Ask, asked. Instruct, instructed. This is already done. And this is present. This is past. Similarly, meet, met. Already we met. You are meeting now. Okay. These are irregular. All these end with ed, ma. All these action words end with ed. But these action words, see, does not end with ed. Meet, met. Leap, leapt. Come, came. Think, thought. Run, ran. Do, did. Take, took. Okay, children, understood? By this, we completed this unit. Who will be Ningtho? I hope you understood this. Have a nice day. Thank you.